we'll bring the left back. Now press that button and hold it. It's going to go through its run-up all by itself. RPMs come up. It's going to cycle the propeller. It's checking the ECU A, checking ECU B. Keep it depressed until these lights clear. So now it's doing an ECU B check, cycling the propeller. Yeah, these are clear. That run-up's complete. That voter switch, go to A. ECU A is working. Go to B. ECU B is working. Back to auto. Okay, same deal on the right side. So hold that in. It'll run up all by itself. Okay, this is extinguished, all good. Check A and B. Engine runs. Engine runs, back to auto. That's pretty much it. Okay. So before we take off, we'll do strobes, landing lights, pumps. I'll turn those on. Pitot heat don't need. Instruments are set, transponder set, and it's 12:34. Okay, any questions?
No questions.
All right. Waukegan Tower, TwinStar 822 Sierra Alpha, ready for takeoff 5.
TwinStar 822 Sierra Alpha, Waukegan Tower, runway 5, proceed on course, cleared for takeoff.
Clear for takeoff on course 20. So you really don't need any brake at all because it's a steerable nose wheel. File's clear, downfield's clear. I'll do your call outs and everything. You'll notice there's going to be some right rudder and left turning tendency. All the way up, full power. We got 100% power, airspeed's alive, cross checks, engine gauges are good. Gas is clear, there's 60, we're going to rotate at 80, there's 70, 75, 80, rotate. Oh, look at that big crane down there. Hey, tap the brakes and bring the gear up. After takeoff check, we got the flaps up, the gears up, and we're all set. Okay, there's 500 feet. Turn left, line 270. To go. Get a feel for it. Now it's real heavy on roll because those wings are so long and it's way out there. You do have to really step on your rudder. So whenever you deflect the ailerons, you should be deflecting the rudders accordingly. You get huge adverse aileron yaw with those ailerons so far out from the center line. So if you're really aggressively banking, you gotta be really aggressively be stepping on the rudder. As you roll out of this left turn, be real aggressive and go right into a right turn. And as you're hitting that aileron, you should be hitting the rudder.
Alright.
And go a real aggressive roll rate. So step, push it over. There you go. Nice. And release. So the rudder, you kind of lead the turn with the rudder and then you lag the rollout with the rudder. It's kind of a little behind. Now, this does have a yaw damper, which will do it automatically, but I'd rather have you get the feel for it. Go up a little bit higher, get out of that turbulence. You can pitch up some more and really kind of climb up, get above this turbulent layer. See that haze out there? If we get just above that, it's smooth as glass. I'm nuts. Miles clear.
Call traffic, TwinStar, final runway 9, call low approach.
Coming down, you can bring the power back a little bit. There you go, I'll just supply some power. There you go. Okay, flaps up, gears up. I'm gonna go around and do another one, that's fine.
Working in there.
Slight right crosswind. Power's good, everything's looking good. Powered idle, gears down. Okay, flap set, go. Take off power, airspeed, engine, everything's good. Okay, tap the brakes, gear comes up. Nice job. Start walking the power back.
Traffic.
All the way up, there you go. There's 100% power. Airspeed's alive. Energy gauges are good. 70, 75, rotate. Just tap those brakes and bring the gear up. It's starting to rain down there. Once it's all the way back, you'll hear it kind of windmill there, okay? So you gotta give it quite a bit of rudder pressure. Now we're gonna increase the right power lever, max continuous. And we'll say, oh my gosh, look at the oil coming out of there, the engine's about to come apart. So we reach over, and we shut off the right engine. So power's the idle, right engine comes off, to feather. Okay? So there you go, the engine's feathered. If we bring this power lever forward, it'll stop that noise, because it's making the gears coming down. Okay, so there's the feathered engine, you're flying around with one feathered, no problem. Cruising along, holding altitude, airspeed's down a bit, but we're fine. Now to get it out of feather, just bring the power lever back, pitch your nose down to above 120 knots, get it windmilling. Creeping up above 120, now we're going to unfeather it. There we go. So you can bring the power lever back forward and it's all back to normal. So, pretty straightforward, not a lot to it. Okay, so go. Just make sure your heels are on the floor and you're not touching that left brake there.
Waukegan Tower, Centurion 57
Alpha. Bring the power all the way back.
Airspace on inbound to Kenosha. I'll be just outside the west end of your airspace.
Centurion 57 Alpha, Waukegan Tower, check out number 3024, transition.
Hold that aileron in there, very nice.
3024,
okay.
And
I'll just roll it down to Charlie.
I'll give you a heads up.